Now turn to part 4. Questions 20 to 25. Look at the 6 sentences for this part. You will hear a girl called Lisa and a boy called Sam talking about a book they have both read. Decide if each sentence is correct or incorrect. If it is correct, choose the letter A for yes. If it is not correct, choose the letter B for no. You now have 20 seconds to look at the questions for part 4. Now we are ready to start. Listen carefully. You will hear the recording twice.
So, Sam, have you finished that book we had to read for school, Lyme County?
Oh, hi, Lisa. Yeah, just last weekend. It took me a long time to get into it. The first chapter was difficult, but in the end, I couldn't put it down.
I liked it from the first page. I've never finished a book so quickly, and normally I don't like reading fiction.
The main character in the story, Paul, was interesting. He hurt his leg badly and couldn't play football with the other kids. But the author didn't make you feel pity for him.
Yes, that was because he was such a strong character. He couldn't do anything active, but he used his time to think about game plans for his team. They depended on him in the end.
He was almost like a coach.
I thought the book was well written, and it had a good plot. There was a bit of mystery about Paul's brother. Did he cause Paul's injury? Was he jealous of Paul? You don't find out until the very end.
I didn't care so much about that. It was the football matches I liked, seen through Paul's eyes. I could imagine exactly what was happening.
The author was clever because when Paul was unhappy, the whole story, the weather, the background, sort of got darker so the reader could feel what Paul was feeling.
There was quite a lot of detail about the techniques of football. I think the author got that just right.
Any more would make it too long and boring for people who weren't mad about football. That side of the book was about right. For me, the best part was that Paul realised what's important in life and how to deal with tough situations. He really grew as a person.
Now listen again.
So, Sam, have you finished that book we had to read for school, Lyme County?
Oh, hi, Lisa. Yeah, just last weekend. It took me a long time to get into it. The first chapter was difficult, but in the end, I couldn't put it down.
I liked it from the first page. I've never finished a book so quickly, and normally I don't like reading fiction.
The main character in the story, Paul, was interesting. He hurt his leg badly and couldn't play football with the other kids. But the author didn't make you feel pity for him.
Yes, that was because he was such a strong character. He couldn't do anything active, but he used his time to think about game plans for his team. They depended on him in the end.
He was almost like a coach.
I thought the book was well written, and it had a good plot. There was a bit of mystery about Paul's brother. Did he cause Paul's injury? Was he jealous of Paul? You don't find out until the very end.
I didn't care so much about that. It was the football matches I liked, seen through Paul's eyes. I could imagine exactly what was happening.
The author was clever because when Paul was unhappy, the whole story, the weather, the background, sort of got darker so the reader could feel what Paul was feeling.
There was quite a lot of detail about the techniques of football. I think the author got that just right.
Any more would make it too long and boring for people who weren't mad about football. That side of the book was about right. For me, the best part was that Paul realised what's important in life and how to deal with tough situations. He really grew as a person.
That is the end of part four. You now have 6 minutes to check and copy your answers onto the answer sheet. That is the end of the test.